One of my favorite psalms has got to be Psalm 1. Psalm 1 says, "Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, or stand in the way of sinners, or sit in the seat of scoffers, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on it he meditates day and night. He's like a tree planted by streams of water, and everything he does prospers." That's good stuff. And for me, the part I've always concentrated on has been his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on it he meditates day and night. Because for me, my struggle's always been my discipline and guarding my time with God every day, right? So I'm reading this psalm and I see something totally new. I see something in the first few verses. I see the slow fade of a man. Listen close. "Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, or stand in the way of sinners, or sit in the seat of scoffers." Did you catch it? First he's walking, then he's standing, then he's sitting. This guy is slowly shutting down. So let's think about this shutdown. Where did this all start in Psalm 1? His counsel. Where does he go for his counsel? Who did he spend his time with? Who did he listen to when he needed counsel? What's he reading? What's he clicking on? What's he watching? It's a slow fade. It's just gonna start flowing out of him. Until now, he's not walking anymore. He's just standing. And he's not even just standing. It says he's standing in the way of sinners. So that means that people who don't know God see him and they're confused by his life and they want nothing to do with the Lord. And now he's sitting, all scabbed up, all numbed out, in the back, if he's even there at all. It's a slow fade when you give yourself away. It's a slow fade when black and white turn. I've been a youth pastor for a long time. I've seen godly men fall. I've seen families that we all look to crumble. I've seen teenagers with a love for God and a passion for reaching people. I've seen them give that all away for just a little more popularity. Let me tell you something. You're not just walking with Jesus today, awesome you in God time, go to bed, wake up in the morning, and then you just crash and burn. It never happens that way. It's a very slow process. One thing to remember is that you are not the first person Satan's ever messed with. He made war with God. Figuring you out wasn't rocket science. So he finds out where your buttons are and he starts punching. And little compromise by little compromise, like a snowball rolling down a hill, one day we find ourselves in a place we thought we would never be, doing things we thought we would never do, but because it was so slow, we're totally rationalizing all of it, because people never crumble in a day. It's always a slow fade.
But a Father up above is looking down in love. Oh, be careful.